Yo, what's up? Dr. Swole here, MD, bodybuilder, back with another video. Today we're going to be talking about intermittent fasting. As a side note, I've been getting a lot of feedback about the audio on my videos, so I got a new microphone. We'll see how it does. Intermittent fasting is the practice of restricting your calories over certain regular time intervals. This has been gaining a lot of popularity over the last few years, and I've been getting a lot of questions about it. So today we're gonna try and clear up some of the misconceptions around intermittent fasting. My main area of expertise is in body composition for bodybuilding. So we're gonna focus on intermittent fasting's application for body composition. We'll talk about some of the pros and cons of implementing intermittent fasting. I've been getting asked a lot for my thoughts on whether there are actual health benefits related to intermittent fasting. We'll touch on those. That is not my area of expertise, but I'll just address it and give my personal opinion. Lastly, if you do choose to implement intermittent fasting, we'll talk briefly about how to do it. First of all, we're gonna talk about intermittent fasting for body composition. In other words, building muscle and losing fat. Now, a lot of people talk about intermittent fasting as a better way to lose weight. I'm gonna say upfront that intermittent fasting doesn't give you any magical benefit for fat loss. Ultimately, what determines whether you lose weight or not is your caloric deficit. So calories in versus calories out. And on the flip side, for building muscle, there is a possible detriment of intermittent fasting, which we'll talk about further in a minute. Based on the data we have right now, I'd say that if you choose to do intermittent fasting or not, it's largely up to personal preference. I'm gonna lay out some of the pros and cons of intermittent fasting so you can better make your decision. All right, so let's talk about the pros of intermittent fasting. As a brief aside, the main ways that intermittent fasting has been implemented in the literature is either to do a shortened time window for which you're eating throughout the day, like fasting for 16 hours and eating for 8 hours. And then there is a 5-2 method where you might eat normally for 5 days of the week and fast for 2 days. And there have also been studies on alternate day fasting. So 1 day eating normally, 1 day fasting. Now, when I say fasting, for the 16-8 method, for example, people usually do not eat anything at all during those fasting hours, but for the 5-2 and alternate day fasting, it usually means just a drastic restriction in calories. Now, I think the biggest reason why you might choose to do intermittent fasting, especially for fat loss, is because you tend to eat less if you're spending fewer hours eating. You've probably noticed this happen on days when, say, you sleep in really late and you end up skipping breakfast. Often, you don't end up actually making up that meal later, and you end up consuming less overall throughout the day. This, I think, is the main reason why intermittent fasting can work for some people. Essentially, whatever helps you enact that calorie deficit is a good thing and will help you lose fat over time. Now, the next advantage of intermittent fasting is simply that it can be more convenient for some people. Just the fact that you're able to, say, skip breakfast or dinner might fit better into people's schedules. Last of all, anecdotally, some people report cognitive benefits with intermittent fasting. Of course, you'll have to try this out to see if it's something that happens for you. Okay, so now let's move on to talk about some of the cons of intermittent fasting. First of all, intermittent fasting comes with an adjustment period. When you first switch over to this new schedule of eating, you're going to feel really hungry at the times you're fasting. Most people find that this adjustment period lasts for about a month. Next, intermittent fasting requires long-term adherence. People might hear intermittent fasting and say, oh, so if I skip breakfast once in a while, it's okay. However, there's actually research showing that people who have a very irregular eating pattern end up having poor metabolic outcomes. Metabolic outcomes usually refers to things like weight, blood pressure, or other factors that can affect your heart health. Another con of intermittent fasting, on the flip side of it being convenient, is that it can interfere with people's social life. This is largely a product of the way our modern culture is set up, where a lot of our social activities revolve around food. Lastly, intermittent fasting can make it difficult for you to consume enough calories when you're bulking. This is basically just the opposite of what we said of its advantage for fat loss. Related to this, there's also a theoretical disadvantage for restricting the hours in which you're consuming protein. Now, after you consume a meal containing protein, your body has an anabolic response that follows a U-shaped curve. Now, what that means is that the protein you consume only can spike muscle growth for a certain amount of time before it levels off and eventually you might turn towards a more catabolic state. So it makes sense that if you're restricting your eating to only a few hours a day, you might be disadvantaging yourself from a muscle synthesis standpoint. However, this is somewhat offset by the fact that if you consume larger amounts of food or more complex foods, such as those containing a lot of fiber or fat, your meal will take longer to digest. The spike in protein synthesis in your body will last longer. All right, so now I'm gonna touch on some of the possible proposed health benefits of intermittent fasting. My interest in intermittent fasting was piqued a lot after seeing a new paper in the New England Journal of Medicine that reviewed the role of intermittent fasting in health. Now, there have been a number of studies now that might be suggesting a possible benefit of intermittent fasting with certain metabolic conditions, longevity, and some other chronic diseases. Two of the possible mechanisms that the paper talks about is metabolic switching and improved stress resistance. Metabolic switching refers to how the body switches from primarily using glucose for energy to ketones. Now, most of the time, if you're eating regularly, your body will use glucose from carbohydrates for energy or convert other nutrients into glucose to use that. However, if you go for a prolonged period without eating, something like 8 to 12 hours, your body starts producing ketones, which it can also use for energy. Now, the thing about ketones is that they also signal other molecular pathways in your body, which may play a positive role in things like glucose regulation in diabetes or other things like blood pressure. The other main mechanism that the paper proposes is stress resistance. What this means is that if you fast at regular intervals, you're repeatedly applying a stress to the cells in your body, which may force them to adapt in a way that can reduce inflammation over time or help them repair themselves, which can impact certain chronic diseases. Now, before we jump to conclusions, I want to talk about some caveats to the intermittent fasting research. Overall, I'd say that this branch of research is still fairly early, and the evidence we have is not strong enough for me to really push intermittent fasting as a way to improve your health. The first thing that struck me when I was reading this review paper is that a lot of benefits associated with intermittent fasting come from actual caloric restriction itself, and not actually the timing of your caloric intake. The next thing is that a lot of the studies that they talk about were actually animal studies and were carried over a short term. Now, usually, if I were to make a recommendation for a health intervention as a physician, I would need to see strong evidence first, which usually involves large-scale studies involving human subjects over an extended period of time, especially if we're talking about things like longevity. Now, this is a big challenge faced by diet research in general, and it's difficult for us to really say for certain what exactly you should be eating for health. Okay, so to quickly summarize what we've talked about so far, I'm gonna give you some of my recommendations on intermittent fasting. First of all, if intermittent fasting helps you to restrict your calories, then it's a good thing. This applies to both weight loss and for health. However, I do think that there is a possible disadvantage of intermittent fasting to bodybuilders, both in a cutting or bulking phase. From a muscle growth standpoint, it makes theoretical sense that you want to have protein available for your body to synthesize muscle for as many hours of the day as possible. And it's very clear that if you're bulking and trying to put in a lot of calories, you probably want to extend your eating window to make sure you can fit that all in. If your goal is fat loss, however, and intermittent fasting helps you restrict your calories overall, I think it's still overall a beneficial thing to do. There is some research ongoing in terms of answering that question as to whether intermittent fasting puts you at a disadvantage for muscle growth, but we'll have to see what happens with that. Now, in terms of the health benefits of intermittent fasting, at this time, I can't make a strong recommendation to do it. However, I've got to say that the research so far has been pretty interesting, and it'll be something to keep an eye on. So ultimately, I think whether you choose to do intermittent fasting or not is going to be up to personal preference. So if I do choose to implement this strategy, how should I do it? First of all, I would suggest starting off with a conservative schedule, something like 16 hours of fasting to an 8-hour feeding window. I'm a big proponent of sustainability, and I think it's important to choose something that fits really well into your lifestyle. Next, from a body composition standpoint, I would recommend spreading out your protein as much as possible throughout your eating hours, at least over 3 to 4 meals. Lastly, be consistent. If you're choosing to intermittent fast, stick with the schedule and stay with it throughout that adjustment period and see what happens afterwards and if it works for you. That's all for now, guys. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you like the video and leave me a comment. This really helps the channel. and at this point I'm still answering virtually all of my comments. Let me know if you want to see me cover other dieting topics. If you haven't already, subscribe, and we'll see you next time.